For safety, please keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the boat at all times and remain seated. While most people end your storybooks with the turn of a page, we are going to start ours by passing through Monstro, the very same whale who swallowed Pinocchio. That's right, folks. We're being swallowed by a whale. Where one tale ends and another tale begins. Of course, our story starts with the Once Upon a Time, but this one also starts with the big bad wolf whose cave is just to our left. He was always after those three little pigs, but luckily they live across the way just to our right in houses of straw, sticks, and 100% guaranteed wolf-proof brick. We are now taking a strange turn, for around this corner is a quaint English village, home to Alice. On one golden afternoon, she chased a white rabbit down the rabbit hole and fell down, down, down to Wonderland, where things became curiouser and curiouser. Just to our right is London Park, where Peter Pan and his friends flew to Neverland, where they never, ever had to grow up. How cute. Straight ahead is Agrabah, a city of mystery and enchantment, where a street rat named Aladdin stole the heart of Jasmine when they met in the marketplace. To this day, they live happily ever after in the Sultan's palace. You may notice the twinkling lights above us. These are the very same lights Aladdin and Jasmine flew over, sideways, and under on a magic carpet ride to a whole new world. Speaking of new worlds, the Cave of Wonders is just ahead, home to the genie of the lamp. Whoever holds this lamp is granted three wishes. Snow White's wish was for a place to get away from the evil queen. Her wish came true in the form of a little cottage to her right, home of the Seven Dwarves. Above our boat to the left is Cinderella's castle. Once upon a time, she went to the royal ball, but when she did not return before midnight, her carriage turned into a pumpkin, which can still be seen on the bridge today. If you look just to the left of our boat, you can see our giant patchwork quilt, inspired by the 1933 Silly Symphony cartoon, Lullaby Land. Now, all of the plants seen here today are 100% pixel-based, and all stay young thanks to Minecraft plant decay. Storybook Land is home to many classic characters, much like J. Thaddeus Toad from The Wind and the Willows, who may be staying at Toad Hall up ahead. It doesn't seem like he's home right now. He's probably off on his motor cart on a wild ride to nowhere in particular. Straight ahead to our left lies the chilly kingdom of Arendelle, where Elsa, Anna, and Olaf spend their days making snowmen. They just can't let it go, can they? Right up ahead is the village where a woodcarver named Geppetto wished upon a star for his puppet Pinocchio to become a real boy. When Pinocchio saved Geppetto from the whale named Monstro, his wish was granted by the blue fairy. Just under this bridge lies a story from under the sea. Prince Eric's palace lands itself on our starboard side, where he met a little mermaid named Ariel. She just wanted to be a part of his world. Folks, that's the end of this story, and if you enjoyed this cruise, my name is Flowerpeep.